Hi guys, back again with another video. Now this video is going to be a Poco F1 update video. So basically the new OS MUI version 10.3.4.0 has been officially launched. So I've already installed it on my phone. I used it for some time and after that I'm making the video. So there are four things that I really liked which actually have some importance to me. So I'll be talking about that. I'll show you the list of what all has been updated. So before I could actually do the reboot and install everything, I took screenshots and I kept that. So let's see the list first, and after that we will talk about the four most important things. Now there are system updates, phone updates, app logs. So you can see the list over here. So basically Widevine L1 support, something new which is Game Turbo. So I'll be showing you all that right now. And security patch to March 2019, phone call related app lock, this one I like. Now the face unlock is supported by app lock too. So now instead of putting your pin or the pattern, you can actually use your face unlock to unlock the app. So that's also good. A lot of lock screen and status bar, notification shades, all of that has been changed. Again, home screen, clock, yes, some issue related to clock. So most of them I don't even know that these kind of issues exist, because I never had them, but apparently a lot of people had that. So all of that has been fixed. Camera, one good thing what they've done is 4K video at 60 fps, and it is great. I'll be talking about that later on. So new AI camera mode, so I'll be doing a camera test to show you all of that. Okay, so settings, recent game speed booster, so that's also something new. So they've actually integrated that. I'll be talking about that later on. MI cloud settings, MI cloud and others. Okay, so that's it. So that's basically all that has been changed. So let's start with the first thing which I actually liked. So, number one, Widevine One support. Now what does Widevine One actually mean? So basically you need Widevine One support to get full HD or to see full HD video on streaming services like Netflix or Amazon Prime or any of these streaming services. If you wanted to use them, you can use them on Poco phone, but it was not running on full HD. So in case you have a full HD phone or a phone which supports Widevine One, then you will see that at the bottom where it says the video, the time and everything which is shown at the bottom. If you look at that, you'll see a small HD symbol over there. So that was missing from Poco. So that has been fixed. Due to copyright issues, I'll not be playing any video through Netflix or Amazon Prime right now. But yes, I've actually tested it and that has been fixed. So number two, Game Turbo. So I'll actually combine it with another one which they have improved, which is Game Speed Booster. So you have Game Turbo and Game Speed Booster. Let's talk about Game Speed Booster first. So basically in Game Speed Booster, it will automatically send all the resources to the game instead of giving all the memory to other things. You can actually restrict them. There's a complete setting that you can change. So I'll show you the setting in Game Turbo. So there is a entire new interface that has been put in. So we'll be looking at that. So our favorite game, PUBG, let's go to PUBG and open that up and then see how that actually works. So we'll go to PUBG Mobile. Now, you see Game Turbo is on, that message came up. And the best thing, which I really like that they put back, I really did not like it when they actually removed it with the last update, which is this. Now the game is complete. It goes to the notch also, which was not working before, which was removed. So now it goes completely till the corner. Now, Game Turbo works like this. I do a swipe on top and now this menu comes up. Now there are so many options. So I have option of Facebook, WhatsApp, record a video. So I can actually do the entire recording, whatever I'm doing on the screen. I can do a recording, screenshot, I can take screenshot, I'll just press that and it'll take a screenshot of whatever is there. So you see that, so done. And it works simultaneously. So you do not have to switch off the game and then go to the other app. So what they've done is when you actually do this, now you have mobile data, Wi-Fi, DND, you can switch on DND so you will not get any messages, auto brightness, lock, unlock, keep the game running. So whether the screen is off or not off, doesn't matter, the game will keep on going on. What happens is sometimes you are playing a game, someone comes in and you don't want them to see that you're playing a game, and you lock the screen. So when the screen gets locked, the game also gets disconnected. If you choose this, game will not get disconnected. So that's something good. Okay, one more thing. Okay, so Facebook, WhatsApp. So one more thing I've noticed is if I want to use WhatsApp now, I'll just show you that. Now it opens in a different window, small window over here, so I can actually control the size of it. So how big or small I want that. Okay, let me just move this first. Okay, so I can have a small window like this and place it in one corner, so I can play my game also and then see that also. Now I'm done. Okay, I'll close it. When I want to WhatsApp again, I just do this, and then WhatsApp again, and there. So I can use it on the side, so I can just message, blah blah blah, everything works fine, and it doesn't disturb the game. So they've actually brought the multitasking function into the game itself. So if not, normally what used to happen is you have to go out of the game and then answer. One more very good thing, even though Poco F1 has a lot of memory and the version that I have is the 8GB one, so I don't really need this feature, but for people who have 6GB RAM, they might have this problem because they have a lot of stuff that the memory gets full. So in case those kind of things happen, you do not have to go out of the game, clear out the cache and all these things. No, you just press this button and it clears the memory automatically. So 479 MB has been cleared while I am in the game. So I can be playing the game, I see that, okay, it's getting a little slow or stutters are coming or whatever is happening. Just do this and then do this and then clear memory and then done. I can continue playing my game. So they've actually worked on the game mode. It's not like the other phones where the game modes give you just regular D&D and all these functions. They've actually increased the function and it can be edited. So I'll show you that now. Okay, so now Game Turbo is not a setting. You cannot go into settings and then see over there. It's a complete different app. So it's like this. So you'll see this icon. I'll choose that, Game Turbo. And it opens up like this. Now you go choose the game. And now you can set whatever settings you want. Now gaming mode. Now it gives you priority of bandwidth. So all the bandwidth will be given to your game instead of other things going on. Like if you're downloading something, WhatsApp is uploading something, or something else is going on in the background, the bandwidth will be given to the game instead of all of that. So you can switch that on. Memory exception. So you can actually put a memory exception. You can go into this and you can choose all the apps which are there. So you put them into exception. So those apps will be now over here, you see, cleared automatically. If you put this on, all these will be automatically cleared as soon as you switch on the game. So normally you won't really need it. Once you go in, you can just hit the clear button and it'll clear everything. But in case you want to put exceptions, then you can do this. Use toolbox. So use toolbox shortcuts to adjust settings while you're playing. So you can, this is on, that's why you see that toolbox which is coming up. Now D&D, if this is on, while your game is on, then you will not get any messages. But anyways, all these features are there in the toolbox. So if you switch on the toolbox, that's the only thing you want to you have to do. Everything else can be controlled from there. Now D&D settings, hands-free call. So in case you get a call, it'll automatically be answered hands-free. What that means is it'll be going to the speaker. It'll not be going to your earpiece. True colors. So the it will switch off auto brightness and reading mode automatically, and it will give you the most amount of colors available. So restricted system gestures. So there are times when you have put on all these fancy features like three fingers swipe and all these things. It'll restrict all of that, and you'll not be able to use that while you are playing the game. But anyways, you have the recording and screenshot mode on the gaming mode itself, so you don't even need that. So those are the settings which are available, and now you can just choose which game you want. You have different views, so you can do this, it shows it like this. If you do it like this, it'll show it like this, and then another view which is this way. So that's all. So that's all that you can see over here. All the settings can be controlled from the game itself with the help of game mode. So, number three, now they have integrated app lock with face unlock. So now in case I lock an app, then You have the option of face unlock also. Before, you just had the pattern or the pin. Now you can just put face unlock, so you just look at it and then the app will be opened. So anyone else will not be able to open it. You won't even know that there was an app lock on it, because it'll keep seeing your face and it'll be unlocking everything. Okay, so let's take an example. So I've locked the dialer now, just for this test purpose. So if I choose the dialer, now it'll not open up. Now it says use your fingerprint or enter the password. Now I'll show my face and it's unlocked. So it's that easy. Okay, now one more big update. Now this is really big. Now Poco F1 in the last update had actually fixed the camera. The camera night mode was excellent. It actually competes with a lot of other cameras which are good at night pictures. So this actually is very good. Now they've improved it even more by going to 4K Ultra HD. Let me just show you that in the settings. So now you have 4K Ultra HD at 60 FPS, not 30 FPS, 60 FPS. Now, last time, if you remember, a lot of people were talking about the slow motion one is not actually that great. It's actually manipulated and all these things were being talked about. I checked this, I made a video and I looked at how smooth the video was and it was excellent. The 60 FPS really works good. So I'll be giving you some samples. I'll make some videos with 4K 60 FPS and 4K 30 FPS and 180p also, and then see the and you will be able to see the difference, how different it's going to be. So that's one big update that they've put in. There is a new AI feature. They've actually improved the AI. They're saying that it recognizes more stuff, which I'll have to test. I'll need to use another Poco F1 which does not have the update and see which one the previous one did not detect, because most of it was being detected by it anyway. So I really don't know about that, but since they are saying it, I believe it. So let's keep it at that. Now, that's the four things which I really liked. Now, one thing which no one is talking about, which I actually realized because I use that feature a lot, is, now you remember a lot of people have been telling you that the top speaker is just gimmicky. The twin speaker thing is gimmicky. It does not work. It's not that great and blah, 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 blah. But they fixed it, and they silently fixed it. They haven't even said it on the update. So that's it for this video. If you like the video, please subscribe, hit the like button and do comment, and I'll see you again with another video. Bye bye.